Good morning students, I welcome you all to yet another session of 10th standard biology. Students, today's session also we continue with lesson number 8, How do organisms reproduce, part 8. So this is the last part of this lesson. Now students, in part 7, we had studied about what is puberty. We studied about the changes which takes place at the time of puberty in case of males as well as females. At the same time, we studied about the menstrual cycle, we studied about the menstrual flow, we studied about how the walls of the endometrium, how the walls of the uterus are broken down and how the menstrual flow takes place. We studied their two definitions, one is a menarche and the other is a menopause. We stated that the first menstrual cycle in the life of a female is called as a menarche, whereas the last menstrual cycle in the life of a female is called as a menopause. So today we will go ahead with the further part of the lesson. Okay? Yeah. So students, now we are going to study about the reproductive health. Now in the reproductive health, we are going to study today about the sexually transmitted diseases. Okay. Now, a sexually transmitted diseases. Sexually transmitted diseases are caused due to the sexual contact. They are spread through the sexual contact. The sexually transmitted diseases are abbreviated as STD, sexually transmitted disease, and they spread through the reproductive fluid, that is nothing but the semen. We have studied that the semen is the secretion of the seminal vesicle as well as a prostate gland. We have studied about this reproductive fluid in the male reproductive system. Now, this sexually transmitted diseases can be caused by bacteria, viruses or other parasites. Some of the sexually transmitted diseases are, one is gonorrhea, syphilis and AIDS. Gonorrhea, syphilis and AIDS. So here I have the picture of the organism which spreads the disease. You can see now this is a pathogen which spreads the gonorrhea. This is a pathogen which spreads gonorrhea. Okay. Now this is the one which spreads syphilis. This is the one which spreads syphilis, and this is HIV, the one which spreads the AIDS. Okay. So students, you have learnt about sexually transmitted disease. Sexually transmitted diseases are the diseases which spread by sexual contact. Okay. Now sexually transmitted diseases can be caused by bacteria, viruses or other parasite. Some of the common sexually transmitted diseases are gonorrhea, syphilis and AIDS. Okay, so students, now let's move over to the next slide. Now students, in the next slide, we are going to study about contraceptives. We are first going to study about the contraceptive. Now what is a contraceptive? Now contraceptive can be a drug, it can be a device or it can be a practice which is used to prevent pregnancy. It can be a drug, it can be a device or a practice which is used to prevent pregnancy. This you call it as what? Contraceptives. We will deal in detail about the contraceptives. Now in contraceptives, the first part we are going to study is about the mechanical barrier. Now in case of the mechanical barrier, there will be a barrier between the sperm as well as the ovum, because of which both of them cannot meet. Since they cannot meet, fertilization will not take place. And you very well know that if fertilization does not take place, it does not result in the formation of a child. That means it does not result in a pregnancy. Okay. Now in this contraceptives, that is a mechanical barrier, the first one we are going to study is, we are going to study about the condoms. So students, here I have the picture of the male condom as well as a female condom. Now in case of the males, the condom is worn on the penis. You know that the penis is responsible for the transfer of the semen. So the condom is worn on the penis so that the semen is collected in the condom. Okay. Now in case of females, that is a female condom, it is inserted into the vagina so that the seminal fluid, that is a semen which is received, will fall into the female condom and will not reach the ovum. So fertilization will not take place, and if fertilization does not take place, you know that we can avoid pregnancy. Okay. Now students, the next picture which you are seeing here is the pills. Now these are some of the pills. These are some of the tablets. Now basically, what are these tablets? Now these tablets are the human hormones. And you know, the hormones are play a crucial role. Crucial role means very important role in the menstrual cycle. And we can adjust the menstrual cycle by using the different hormonal pills. But let me tell you, the use of the hormonal pills has a lot of side effect. Okay, so by using this hormonal pills, we can prevent the unwanted pregnancies. So I'll read it now. Contraceptives, mechanical barrier, condoms. It is worn on the penis in males and vagina in females and serves as a barrier between the sperm and the ovum and prevent fertilization. Drugs, that is the pills as I told you. The drugs are commonly taken orally as pills. However, these drugs can cause hormonal imbalance. Okay, yeah. Now let us go to the next slide. Now students, in the next slide, you are seeing an intrauterine device. Now in this intrauterine device, can you see a T-shaped structure inside? The white T-shaped structure inside, I just highlighted. So this is the white T-shaped structure you are seeing inside. Yeah. Can you see the white T-shaped structure? I highlighted. So this is the white T-shaped structure. Now this T-shaped structure is a loop of copper. It is a copper loop which is inserted into the uterus. Because this loop, copper loop, is inserted inside the uterus, that's the main reason it is called as an intrauterine device. Okay, this copper tube, it reduces the mobility of the sperm. Mobility means, you know, the sperm has to swim and reach the ovum. So if the mobility is reduced, it will take more time for the sperm to swim and reach the ovum. That is one. At the same time, this copper tube prevents the implantation. All of you know implantation. It is taking off the embryo to the wall of the uterus. But still, you know that copper is a metal. Copper is a metal because, and this copper can undergo rusting. If it undergoes rusting, it causes irritation to the inner lining of the uterus. So this is one of the drawback of copper tube. Copper tube is a contraceptive device which is placed in the uterus to prevent pregnancy. It can cause the irritation to the inner lining of the uterus, as I stated now. So students, we have studied about the mechanical barrier, and in the mechanical barrier, contraceptives as a mechanical barrier, we studied about the condoms, we studied about the pills, and we studied about the intrauterine device, that is copper tube. Now let us go to the next slide. Students, in the next slide, we are going to study about the different surgeries which can be done to prevent pregnancy. So contraceptive, that is surgical method. Now in the surgical method, I will just explain you with the diagram here, students. Now the first diagram which you are seeing here is that of tubectomy. The first diagram you are seeing here is of tubectomy. You can see here, students, this is the fallopian tube. Okay, and you know that the ovary produces the ovum and the sperm is going to swim and reach the ovum. You know the sperms are deposited in the vagina. It is going to swim and it will try to reach the ovum, correct? Okay, so here what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the fallopian tube and tie the fallopian tube. Okay, if I cut the fallopian tube and tie the fallopian, cut the ends and tie the ends of the fallopian tube, in that case what will happen? The sperms cannot reach the ovum. If the sperms are not going to reach the ovum, fertilization will not take place and it will not result in the formation of a baby, or it will not result in pregnancy. Okay, so tubectomy is a type of operation in which the fallopian tube is cut. Now fallopian tube is a part of the female reproductive system, so tubectomy is a surgical method used as a contraceptive in case of females. Now students, we have the next method, that is vasectomy. What is vasectomy? Vasectomy is the cutting of the vas deferens. You can see the vas deferens being cut over here and tied. You know that the sperm testis is going to produce the sperm, so the sperms will be transported only till this part. Beyond this part, the sperms cannot travel and the sperms will die a natural death after a particular time. Okay, so now the semen produced is not going to have sperms after vasectomy because the sperms are not allowed to reach the seminal vesicle and the prostate gland. So, vasectomy is a surgical method of contraception in case of males. So, let's do the reading part now. So, contraceptive surgical method. Surgical methods are safe in the long run. Surgery itself can cause infections and other problems if not performed properly. Vasectomy. So, vasectomy in case of males. It is a blocking of the vas deferens so that the transfer of sperm is prevented. Tubectomy. It is a blocking of the fallopian tube so that the egg and the sperm do not unite with each other so that no fertilization and no pregnancy. So, this is contraceptive, that is surgical method. Now, let's move over to the next slide, students. Now, students, in the next slide, we are going to study about abortion. Okay. Now, abortion is usually done to remove the unwanted pregnancy. Before the pregnancy reaches the full term, that is, you know, the full term of the pregnancy is for 9 months. Before the pregnancy reaches the full term, what is there? The fetus is removed out of the mother's body. But this abortion can be done in the initial stages of pregnancy. Once it crosses a particular limit, it is hazardous for the mother's body. So, abortion is not advised. Okay, so here you can see a small fetus. I can just enlarge this photo. Here you can see a small fetus being removed out of the mother's womb. That is, here you are doing the abortion. Okay, now there is misuse of abortion. Okay, now abortion is misused by people. Now, how people misuses the abortion? Now, if the parents come to know that the child which is developing in the mother's body is a female child, according to the Indian society, there are many parents who prefer the male child. And what they do is they try to destroy or they try to abort the female child in the mother's uterus itself. So, this is a misuse of abortion. Okay. Now, to have a healthy society for the future generation, we have something called as a sex ratio. That is, we should have a particular proper ratio of male and female in the society. And to have a proper sex ratio, we should have some number of males and at the same time, some equal number of females are required. But if we keep on aborting the female child at the time of development itself, don't you feel the female population will keep on decreasing? So, that means there will be an upset in the sex ratio, which will be difficult, okay? Because of which the prenatal sex determination, that means when the child is developing in the mother's uterus, at that time we cannot detect the sex of the child. This detecting the sex of the child when the child is in the mother's uterus is called as a prenatal sex determination. Is called as prenatal sex determination, and it is totally prohibited by the Indian government because people are misusing it. If they find that the child is female, then the females are aborted, and if the female childs are aborted on a regular basis, in that case, as I told you, in the future generation there will be an upset in the sex ratio. Okay, now abortion. Now, abortion is usually done to remove the unwanted pregnancy. Misuse of abortion. Abortion is misused by people who do not want a particular child, especially the girl child. For a healthy society, the male-female sex ratio must be maintained. Because of the reckless female feticide, that is killing the female child, child sex ratio is declining at an alarming rate in our sections of our society. Therefore, prenatal sex determination has been prohibited by law. Okay, so here we have different posters coming here. Save the girl child. Okay, if there is no he without she. See, for the development of a society, to have a population, she is very, very important. She is a mother who gives birth to a he. Correct? Okay, so this is just for your awareness. Now, impact of reproduction on population. Okay, So that we will see now. As far as countries like India is concerned, the population is increasing. Okay, so does an increase in the population have any impact on our life? Yes, it has got impact on our life. So let us see what is the impact of population explosion. Point number one, insufficient employment. People are running short of jobs. Insufficient housing. There are no proper housing facilities for the increasing population. Insufficient health services. We don't have ample amount of hospitals to admit the sick ones. Next, insufficient education services in many of the rural places in India. Again, we are running short of schools. So that is insufficient education services. So these are some of the impacts of population explosion. That means we need to control the population. And how can we control the population? We can control the population by using different contraceptive devices. If we do not control the population, now already we are near to the population explosion, it will become severe day by day. Okay, so let's do the reading part. Reproduction results in an increase in the population of the organisms. The rate of birth and death in a given population will determine its size. The rate of birth, number of children born and number of people dying will determine what is the size of that particular population. The size of the population is a concern for many people. Okay? This is because an expanding population makes it harder to improve everybody's standard of living. Standard of living means with how you live in a society is your standard of living. If the population increases, I told you impact of population here, okay? So what happened? The standard of living decreases and the poverty increases. Okay, students, this marks the end of this lesson. And now let's look into the assignment questions. Okay, assignments, define contraceptive. As we said that it is a devices or it is a practice which is used to control pregnancy. Okay, explain the different methods of contraception. You have mechanical barrier as well as surgical barrier. Write short notes on the misuse of abortion, that is prenatal sex determination is prohibited in India, that you have to mention. And then how the female feticide means how the female children are aborted, because of which how there is an upset in the sex ratio. Next, impact of reproduction on population, that we saw how it impacts employment, the housing, the the educational part. Okay, so all this your assignment question. Okay, students, I hope all of you have understood this session of biology. Okay, so thank you so much.